hear your names. Mr. Brown, Mr. White, Mr. Blonde, Mr. Blue, Mr. Orange, Mr. Pink.
Why am I Mr. Pink?
Because you're a faggot, all right?
Hello friends, this is Ollie and welcome to Embrace the Film. Today we're going to talk about Reservoir Dogs, the debut film from Quentin Tarantino. The film debuted in 1992 and swept up Hollywood in a firestorm, turning its stars Harvey Keitel, Tim Roth, Chris Penn, Steve Buscemi, Lawrence Tierney, and Michael Madsen into legends almost overnight.
You wanna fuck with me? I'll show you who you're fucking with!
You wanna shoot me, you little piece of shit?
Kid shouldn't play so rough.
The story follows a team of criminals assembled to pull off a jewel heist in Los Angeles. But when the job goes wrong, suspicion begins to arise that one of them may be a police informant. The thing that makes this film interesting is that it's a heist film where you never see the heist. The story is contained mostly to a dingy warehouse, cutting away to only brief moments of their escape. Yet, Tarantino is able to keep ramping up the intensity of the situation as he tells the audience who the informant is and allows us to watch the walls close in around him. Tarantino gives no real visual cues as to who the informant is before he tells you. Instead, he goes in the exact opposite direction, stripping the characters of anything that would make them unique. He wipes away their names and gives them aliases that are simply colors. He strips them of any identifying clothing by putting them all in the same black suits and sunglasses. Most of the characters even carry themselves the same way, acting like a group of alpha males all vying for leadership, making them all in essence the same person. The only one standing out being Mr. White, because of the compassion he shows toward Mr. Orange during this whole ordeal. I suppose this could have been done to point the finger toward Mr. White before the identity of the informant was revealed.
You're under arrest, sugar!
What was the name of the chick who played Christy Love?
Pam Grier.
No, it wasn't Pam Grier. Pam Grier was the other one. Pam Grier did the film. Christy Love was like a Pam Grier TV show without Pam Grier.
So, who was Christy Love?
The fuck should I know?
The dialogue in this film is powerhouse. Like with most of his work, Tarantino is not only able to make these characters modern and contemporary, but somehow make them all sound so cool and slick at the same time. My recommendation, if you haven't seen Reservoir Dogs, you need to. I don't know how you've gotten through life without seeing it. This film is a clever, pulse-pounding crime thriller with creative, dynamic characters, a dark and very fitting setting, thought-provoking and quotable dialogue, and a highly ingenious concept that still stands the test of time today. Many films have tried to emulate its success, but none have ever come close. This is one you will want to own and watch again and again. Once you've seen it, you won't be able to stop talking about it. I myself have seen this film about 1,000 times, and I still am not sick of it. Tarantino somehow makes me fall in love with these characters over and over again every time I watch it. It's almost impossible for me to choose one specific favorite scene from this movie. There are so many memorable ones. Everything from the Like a Virgin conversation at the opening of the film, to Mr. Pink's shootout escape, to Mr. Blonde's stuck in the middle dance sequence. When I first saw this movie, it made me want to run out, buy a straight black suit, a thin tie, some thick sunglasses, and just go rob banks. Every character in the film just makes you want to be as badass as they are. I'm proud to say that Reservoir Dogs was my first real introduction to film. It's probably the one movie that made me really start to analyze movies and respect the art of making films. It wasn't the film that made me want to make movies, but it was definitely second in line. I personally have to give Reservoir Dogs an A+. Now, I'm sure there are flaws within it that I'm too blinded by how much I love it to see, but this movie is fucking phenomenal. Anyone that loves movies or loves crime stories needs to run out, dish out a few greenbacks, and pick up a copy of this movie. It'll change your life.
Larry, stop pointing that fucking gun at my dad!
I hope you guys enjoyed today's segment. Make sure you hit the sub button to stay up to date on all my latest reviews. Click the bell if you'd like to be notified on all my latest uploads. Make sure you drop a like, and I will see you all next time. Thanks for watching.